Hello, everyone. Gameaholic1994 here. And today's video is a tutorial on adjusting track conditions. It was actually at the very time when I recorded this that I found out there was more to adjusting track conditions than I thought. I mean, between each and every spline point, it's like a different piece of track altogether. At first, I thought it worked as when I click on one track to adjust the condition, it would adjust all the tracks throughout the whole round. There's got to be an easier way to do this. Even with the track set to 100%, I still see some sway. I guess it's the track itself.
Oh.
It doesn't look to me like there's something in the config text file that I could change to make it sway less. Unless. I think this tutorial kind of video is turning into an experiment kind. Despite what I highlighted, I apologize in advance if this is not the right thing for me to do with assets like this. Nonetheless, this custom version of track is for personal use only, and will not be redistributed in any way. But if this isn't allowed, I'll delete the track asset that I cloned and modified. Looks like today's experiment was a failure. I guess this track just isn't the right kind for me to use for driving trains at high speeds. I guess I'll just have to find another track to use. Maybe switch back to the track that was originally used for Sodor Island 3D's Island route, and many other routes. That track always ran much smoother and had little to no swing. Unless there's another way to really flatten my current track, and make it much smoother. If you have any suggestions, please tell me in the comments below. Until then, I'll at least keep it and see if there is a way to make it work with my current track. Until next time, this is Gameaholic 1994, signing off.